What's up? What's going on? Peep Squad is in the building, baby. So let's get into it. Let's talk about Ryan Henry and his best friend Anthony and Nina involved, baby. It is going down. It seems like the best friend is very upset. He is mad. He is out here in these streets. He is doing a press tour, baby. He's on the Shade Room. He's in people's comments saying it is true. He's complaining about people that are coming onto his IG page because they're commenting about the situation that he exposed to the world when he was feeling himself, and he let us know that he was out here taking some painkillers and drinking that Remy, baby, and then he ended up posting on Instagram what Ryan had did to him, allegedly, and it's not really allegedly, but Ryan done slept with his children's mother, like, Lord have mercy, has slept with his son's mother, and Ryan is the godfather to his son too as well. I was like, Lord have mercy, it is going down, baby. I was like, he's upset and he's mad, but he's telling the world the business, so of course they're gonna come to his Instagram and ask some questions and call him out. It is what it is. When you play with the nature of the beast of the game, baby, be ready for the blows that are gonna come with the situation too as well. And I find that it was very irresponsible for Anthony to be on live to be interviewing about his situation with his son in the room. You know, he was doing an interview with Storm and he was just basically talking all this ish and everything that was going on between him and Ryan, him feeling like he wanted to depart from this earth, him drinking, taking pills, going through, you know, his son's mother's phone and basically calling out Ryan, just talking about all types of adult stuff while his son was in the room. Like, damn, like, you really out here that bad for attention to get your story out? You can't take your son in another room so he can't hear you badmouth Ryan or talk about his mother and then talk about your mental state and things like that? That ain't for no child, baby. You were out here doing too much. And he says that he wants Nina back, his son's mother. He wants her back after she done cheated on him, baby. He wants her back. He wants that family back. And he says he loves the Puerto Rican, the Rican, baby. I was like, Lord have mercy. He wants to take her back, but I don't think she's going to be feeling him like this because he's all on the blogs. He's all on Instagram. He's all on YouTube just running a business. If anything, it's going to make her more upset. I was like, Lord have mercy. And while he was interviewing Ryan Henry's mother, reached out to him to basically probably tell him to get his but off of live, get off the internet running your business and running your mouth, especially when you don't want people to comment about the situation or post under your picture with your son, and you don't want people dogging out your son's mother, but you're out here doing the job your damn self, and you think people are not going to respond? You think people are going to follow your rules and your regulations? No, they're going to do what they want to do, how they want to do it, and when they want to do it. So it is what it is. I was like, Lord have mercy. It seems like he's not going back to black women, baby. So it is what it is. He is not here for the sisters. He was back in the day with his first son. But once he got a hold of to the Rican, the Puerto Rican, which he says Puerto Rican is black. And it is what it is. And he wants her back. And Puerto Rican and black, including him, make good babies. He didn't say black on black make good babies. He said it afterwards, but he posted that to Instagram. And also, he was being questioned whether he put his hands on Nina, his son's mother, and he said no, she put her hands on him. And basically, you know, he still got the police reports and the receipts, baby. I was like, okay, he's out here doing a whole lot. And so he proceeds to let us know that, you know, him and Ryan was going on to a vacation in August 11th, you know what I mean, or around August, and they were supposed to be having a family trip, him, Ryan, Ryan's children, and his children too as well. But the day before, Ryan was over there smashing Nina. Nina wants her some Ryan. You know Ryan can't keep it. You know Ryan can't keep his hot dog in the bun. You know Ryan is out here in these streets. Ryan is for the streets. Rachel done already told us, yes, Ryan is wrong for sleeping with his best friend's woman and also being the godfather to their son too as well, because that's an icky, icky, sticky, sticky situation. And baby, you already know how Ryan gets down. Ryan likes women attached. Ryan likes thrill. He likes consequence. He likes suspense. And he likes other people's property too as well. If there ain't no thrill in a relationship with you where he might be caught or he's doing something wrong, then he ain't gonna mess with you. He likes the thrill of the situation. That's just how it is. And Anthony, Ryan's best friend, basically says that he was told by Nina that Ryan and his son's mother were messing around for at least a year, but he's not too sure about the situation. And he also says that when he asked Nina about the situation of her and Ryan having an affair, basically, you know, did he use protection? She said yes. And mind you, his son was in the room. I was like, yo, he's doing too much. Like, why are you talking like that around your child, baby? Like, you doing too much. And he also let us know that he is not too happy and not too thrilled with Ryan, because Ryan basically says he does not care about the situation and he's not here for Anthony, point blank, period. And he said there's more to the story. So Ryan is speaking his truth, speaking a little bit of his truth, but you know how Ryan is. Ryan ain't gonna own up or admit to nothing unless he has to. But Ryan did have a little bit to say, so let's check this out. I was like, Ryan is out here in these streets wilding, baby. He is doing the most, for real, for real. So let's check this out.
So he's making himself look worse. Look worse to who? Y'all don't like me anyway. Y'all don't like me anyway. He's making himself look worse. Worse to what? But y'all don't like me anyway. Y'all don't even know what's real behind that story. I'm not gonna say anything. I'm definitely not gonna say anything. You know what I mean?
What's going on?
It's not black and white as y'all think.
It's definitely a lot of people that want to say a lot of. You know what I mean? I take my punches on the chin. I take my punches all the way on the chin. But I ain't gonna say nothing. But don't get no lies. I don't be threatening no nothing. Don't let no. Come on, man. What I look like? I can't. So, yeah, man. It is what it is. Off of that.
So you guys already know how Ryan feels about the situation. Ryan is like, I got some secrets that I can tell. And Ryan is basically saying that he can come out these streets and say some things too as well. And Ryan is not feeling Anthony at all talking to the blogs. And Ryan is very upset with Anthony because Anthony done told Rachel, because he didn't want Rachel to know. Because Ryan really thinks he has a shot with Rachel again. There ain't no way you're going to get back with Rachel. And so Anthony was really upset that Ryan basically was upset only at him because he told Rachel, but not upset that he actually took his best friend's woman. Like, Lord have mercy, what is really going on with this situation? I was like, Anthony's out here doing the most, baby. He has the right to speak his mind and say what's on his mind and say what's on his chest and get it out, baby. But at the meantime, in between time, you still gotta know it's some bitch is in the situation too as well. You don't look too good out here in these streets too as well, because Anthony told us that he didn't get the information that he wanted from his son's mother, Nina. So therefore, he went to the blogs because he was up all night having a bender. So he went to the blogs and basically, and that was it. He posted to his Instagram the situation. It took less than 3 minutes for people to take the information, put it all over the place. And Anthony was following them and commenting under people that were talking about the situation between Ryan and Anthony, and Ryan, you know, taking his best friend's woman. It is what it is. I believe Nina is still over there waiting for Ryan. She's still seeing Ryan and she wants to be with Ryan. That's just gonna be the situation, and it is what it is. Ryan is definitely wrong with this situation. Ryan definitely is not the first time that he done been with somebody else's woman, and it's not gonna be the last time unless he ties the knot and somebody can tie him down and keep him faithful. Ryan, can you be faithful? I was like, Lord have mercy, what's really going on with this situation? Like, it was going down. It was going ham. I was like, It seems like Anthony is very upset, and he just really want people to know how he found out that Nina was cheating on him is because Nina went to the bathroom and his son, I guess, seen the phone or saw his mother put in the password, and that's how Anthony got the password, baby, because in the back of his mind, he felt some type of way that Ryan and his son's mother was out here doing some things. He felt a certain type of way, so therefore he checked the phone and he found out that Ryan and Nina was in a relationship, and they was in a relationship for almost a year and change, allegedly. Like, damn. And he was like, oh, she was Ryan's side piece. I was just like, Lord have mercy, baby, you ain't gonna let this go. You're gonna let the world know what's going on with this situation. And he's basically, he wants Nina back. He wants the mother of his son back in his life. It is what it is. He worships her and he wants to be with her. So it is what it is. I was like, Lord have mercy. And he's just really, really upset. He says that he is still following Ryan on Instagram because he wants to know what Ryan is saying and what Ryan is posting about him too as well. And this is one of the reasons why he's really responding, is because Ryan was out here like, yo, I don't really care about what this dude is saying. Like, he's doing some foul-ish. I ain't gonna speak on it. You guys don't know the whole truth. It's deeper than what you think it is. So Ryan basically is saying some things. Ryan could come out and basically, you know, say what really happened, what really went down with the situation. You put two to two together, and then from there you can find out the truth. But it seems like Anthony's child's mother was not happy. The son's mother, Nina, she was not happy, and she went with Ryan. So, and if she's supposed to be with you, she's supposed to love you and have a bond with you and have a child with you, then why would she sleep with your best friend? She knows how much that would hurt you. She know how much that would destroy the family, and she didn't care, and she's a mother. So therefore, she ain't gonna care the second time around when you take her back, Anthony, because it's when she wants to come back, and Nina might not come back unless she can't afford to, you know, take care of herself and live comfortable by herself. But if she can afford to live comfortably by herself, she's definitely not going back to Anthony. That ship has sailed. She's on that Ryan train, baby. Maybe if Ryan denounced her, she might go back to him, but it is what it is. You know, Ryan has a healthy appetite, and just not one can satisfy him. He has to have his cake and eat it too, whether it hurts his best friend, whether it hurts Rachel, whether it brings embarrassment or shame upon the family. Ryan is going to do what Ryan's going to do all day, every day. Ask the ladies at Black Ink Crew Chicago. 9 Meg, baby. I was like, Lord have mercy. And also, Anthony is basically upset because Ryan has been saying that he is broke. And he said he is not broke. And he doesn't understand why Ryan is out here calling him broke. He feels a certain type of way about that situation. I was like, Lord, Ryan is going to come out swinging if Ryan do come out. Because if Ryan comes out and says anything, he has to confirm. And then also, that's going to leave a taste in Rachel's mouth, and he don't know what type of taste he might leave in Rachel's mouth if he starts to defend himself about the situation. But I don't know how Ryan can really defend himself if he's sleeping with his best friend's, you know, children's mother, and he is the godfather, unless they were not together. Anthony says that they was on rocky ground when he found out that his girlfriend Nina was cheating with Ryan. So they may have a rocky relationship too as well, but that still doesn't give Ryan the right to do it. But Ryan is a man, and he's gonna do what he wants to do. Does that make it right? Morally, it's very wrong. Morally, it's just wrong completely. There's no excuse for it. So I don't see Ryan speaking up because there's no excuse for it. And also, Anthony says, Ryan, go pull up on Van, because Anthony is alleging that Ryan wants to, you know, pull up on him. And Anthony says Ryan told someone else that he wanted to pull up about 3 times on Anthony. And that's what Anthony is saying. Ryan wanted to pull up on him. And he said he does not want to fight Ryan at all, point blank, period. He told Ryan to go fight Van. I was like, Lord have mercy. He is going in. And also, Anthony wants everybody to understand his hurt and his pain, and he wants the world to know. Baby, you should have did this in private. You should have did this quietly too as well. And also, Anthony said he never ever thought about having a relationship or being physical or intimate with Rachel, which is Ryan's baby's mother or son's mother, because he respects Ryan, he respects her, and he says he has been at Rachel's house intoxicated. He slept over Rachel's house, and he never once tried to do anything with Rachel at all. And he had to tell Rachel because he wanted Rachel to know. He wanted Rachel to know so maybe she can discipline Ryan. She can't do nothing to Ryan. She can't discipline him. Only thing that she can do is remove her love from him him and being in a relationship with Ryan. But Anthony is feeling a certain type of way and he's very upset. And it looks like he's really like digging a real big hole for himself, and he's going to probably regret it too as well, because he said he's been friends with Ryan for almost 11 years and they're very close friends. And also Anthony says he suffered from mental illness and things like that too as well, and he almost tried to depart from this earth with his own hands, but he felt that he could still live. And he's also very hurt that he survived stage three colon cancer, and only to find out his woman, the love of his life, his Puerto Rican princess, has been cheating with Ryan while he did have cancer. But he said that this hurts so much. He could destroy and defeat cancer, but losing his best friend and his son's mother really hurts him the most. He's in so much pain right now, and this is why he's probably out here on the blogs, and he's going to regret it. Hopefully Anthony stays prayed up, and it doesn't look like a good situation for him, and it looks like he's going to have a lot of regrets about coming to the media too as well, because a lot of people's going to come for his throat, and he's already upset because people are coming for his throat on Instagram and trying to expose him as being not a so great guy at all, and accusing him of mistreating his son's mother, Nina. So this situation is going to end ugly, and it's just sad because Anthony doesn't look like he's mentally equipped to deal with this situation. But he also mentioned that Rachel was with Jeremiah. She had a serious relationship. But also Anthony admitted too as well that him and Nina broke up and she was dating somebody else and she was in a serious relationship, and then they got back together. So it looks like the relationship between Anthony and Nina wasn't really that stable. He was a come up probably, and she came up even further with getting with Ryan. And Ryan got a history of being with other men and women. He is down with OPP. Yeah, you know me.